I'm Bob.
And I'm Rob.
Well, kind of Rob. The real Rob is actually out working hard, long hours to get you your packages that you all may have ordered. And we had to do a little bit of improvising and get somebody close to Rob. We'll just call him Standin' Rob, right?
You can kind of think of me as Bruce Lee in Game of Death. We do the best with what we got.
Recently, Rob and I released a full version of the documentary for Attack of the Moon Zombies, Behind the Sliding Door. This full version of the documentary was never seen by the public in its entirety, only in segments on YouTube. The full version was only released on DVD to Rob and I and to Christopher R. Mim. It can now be viewed on our YouTube channel in its full version. This full version on DVD also included over 40 minutes of deleted scenes, outtakes, and bloopers that we did want to share with Christopher R. Mim. The thing is we do not want to share all 40 minutes with you today for sake of some of it was just so bad and so boring. Some jokes just didn't make it. We want to just share with you the best of the worst as well as the bloopers.
I am good at bloopers.
Yes, Rob, you are the master of bloopers and multiple takes.
To be honest, a lot of what was cut was for a reason. Some of the jokes fell flat. Not my jokes. My jokes never fall flat. Those were all Bob's.
One thing we wanted to do while sharing this with you was to also add a little bit of commentary before each segment so that you get a little bit of background as to maybe why something was cut or also just even the process we went through in making this documentary. The first segment that we shared on YouTube was Rob and I introducing the trip we were going to take to Minneapolis. Now this segment itself had the most footage out of all of the outtakes.
When Bob and I film a lot of stuff, many times we just run with it and see what happens. We improvise and we see what magic happens. I usually produce a lot of magic.
Yeah, what we're going to share with you is really half of the footage that we had left over. Really the best of it.
We hope you enjoy the outtakes from part one of Behind the Sliding Door.
Well, Bob, what do you think of starting this out, this whole trip that we're going to go on to Minnesota and experience this whole movie thing for the first time, just going down and just getting to the nuts and bolts of how he, you know, Chris makes his movies and just brings this, his genius really to life. It's just going to be great. How do you think we should kick this off? How do you think we should get this going?
I don't know. So I know there's probably a lot of people viewing from Minnesota out there, but you know, these films take place mainly in Wisconsin.
Yes, yes.
So we need to represent, you know. So we're going to take a road trip, and that's what we're talking about here. We're coming from Appleton, Wisconsin.
Over to?
Arden Hills, Minnesota.
Minnesota.
Yeah.
You got to say that right.
Yeah.
Minnesota.
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 So we're going to work on that.
Yeah.
And we got 5.5 hours.
We
got to
learn the language.
We got 5.5 hours to, I think I got one of those CDs that we can throw in that helps us with the dialect.
And the enemy I'm speaking of, you know, that we're going is Brock Lesnar. I mean, he's pretty dangerous guy, and he's from Minnesota. I mean, anybody would be afraid of the guy. I mean, that's definitely enemy territory. So that's why
Brock
we're
Brock Lesnar.
Come on, you don't know who Brock Lesnar is?
No.
I need to educate this guy. He's the UFC heavyweight. You know, he's like the champion of UFC. Well, he might have been taken down a couple matches, but, you know, this guy's huge. You ever see him? He's from Minnesota. He's from the farmland.
Oh, I just knew about Jesse Ventura.
No, he's a big-time wrestler guy. I mean, you cross him the wrong way, crossing the street, and your butt's on the ground. So that's why we got to be trembling. You know, we got to walk around.
I'm more afraid of Brett Favre.
Well, I think Brock Lesnar could take the guy. I mean, I don't think he's afraid of him.
Maybe not right now. I mean, I think his wife would probably say something different.
I bet he's more afraid. Brock would be more afraid of Deanna than he would be Brett Favre.
Yeah, I'm sure they don't want to hear about sports.
No. Yeah. Okay, let's get back on task.
Sorry. It's a dental floss container.
Come on, it was a pill bottle. I mean, it was obvious that's what he used. I mean, any super fan would know this.
It's a dental floss container.
Well, anyways, I appreciate.
Don't you listen to the commentary on the movies? You call yourself a super fan? I should just be taking this trip
by myself. I should leave. No, really. No, what we're getting at is
Rob is a real big fan.
Yes, and his brilliance in using everyday things to represent his props in the film is what we're getting at.
Well, okay.
He's very, very good at this.
Look at the Look at the bat from Terror from Beneath the Earth, okay? I love the teeth. I wanted to go eat corn.
Yeah.
You know, the minute I saw those teeth, I was hungry for corn.
Corn, I mean, maybe cornbread. I mean, just seeing the stuff dripping out of his teeth.
Dude, the teeth were corn cob spears. That's why I said that.
Oh, I thought you were going on the cornbread thing. Anyways, yeah, that's great. It's great, you know. You know, he definitely. Okay, yeah, you got me there. Wait, we'll give you a taste of all.
We're gonna take you behind the scenes, and we're going to show you a little bit of independent Mimiverse film magic, and you're gonna be able to see things.
Did you just coin that? I like that. I think Pierce would like that.
You like that?
Say that again. I want to hear that.
What did I just say? Mimiverse film magic.
I think we should. That should be something in the credits.
Maybe
we
should make a T-shirt of that.
I think so. I think he'd love that. And
Mimiverse
right here,
film magic.
I think that needs to be. You were just experiencing Mimiverse
history.
Film magic, and this was history, man.
Coined a phrase.
You need to get credit for that. Chris, are you listening here? Anyway. Oh, he's just going to be mesmerized. I just can see his face now. It's going to be something like this. That's kind of the face
I
was thinking.
So.
Yeah.
Maybe you can see that if he lets us in his house.
That doesn't happen. Unfortunately, this video cannot be made, and so you fans out there better hope he lets us in.
Yeah.
Because if not...
Did he release that restraining order on you?
I think they have that. Actually, the date we get there on Saturday, it's actually
good.
Up at 7 o'clock.
Okay, we should be good.
Oh, good. All right.
Yeah, all right.
Great. I'm happy.
Yeah.
We timed that just perfectly, didn't we?
Yeah.
I mean, the last one was a doozy. We don't need to go into that.
No,
anyways.
Yeah, we won't cover that one.
So, let's start with the canoe cops. I mean, come on.
Yeah, those guys are awesome.
I think they're, I mean, they make the
films. I don't know when he's coming out with that canoe cops film, but, I mean.
I personally.
There will be lines around the block.
I personally think if he really wants to make them, like, epic fan, you know, actors and everything. The canoe has to fly, man. It's got to fly. It's got to have wings.
Well, you know,
you might tie it into
the old Destination Outer Space thing.
You can put like a glass dome over it and have it flying and then have the canoe guys in there and flying around in space. I mean, it'd be classic.
You have such great ideas, man. You know what?
You know, he coins really good phrases, too. Like he'll come up with this really cool phrase all right off the top of his head. Watch. Here it comes.
What, like the Christopher Mim... I forgot.
Come on, you said it before, man.
I forgot it. It's like I come up with these awesome sayings and I can't remember them.
You want to coin this because he wants to put this in your movie and have it in the credits. So come on, you got to say it. Tell him what you said. Christopher Films...
No.
Magical Wonderland. No, that's Mickey Mouse
that's not it. it was pretty cool.
Yeah, we'll think of it as we get going here.
Yeah, maybe I'll remember it when we're like done.
After the film is in camera or off, you know. Anyways.
So if you see that there's some glitches when we're talking here, it's not because of our lack of editing skills. It's because
the camera tilted. It's not us.
Yeah, no, it's not us. It's
something else. But anyways, what I want to get at.
That's all right. We're gonna have a lot of.
Part two was the infamous road trip.
This was really a lot of improvisation, and we had discussed a lot of it ahead of time.
Due to part two being the most planned segment that we did have the least amount of cut footage from that segment. I can say, as you maybe saw from the footage, that it was the most fun segment for us to do, though.
And yes, Bob was really driving most of the time. Naughty Bob.
Well, we definitely are paddling now. All right. Oh, man, that's not good. We need to do that over. Loser! Are we there yet?
No, we're not there yet.
You have the force. Are we there yet?
No.
The next couple clips you'll see show how Christopher R. Mim was involved in the creative process of this documentary. Unlike the first couple segments of the documentary, where it appears that we just kind of dropped in on Christopher R. Mim, you'll see that he actually had an idea that we were coming and that he did have some input into what we were doing. Specifically, the segment that involved us showing our pitch to Chris was... we have a little bit of footage here from him talking with Liz Kaiser about how they're going to react to our pitch. I hope you enjoy this couple of segments and see that we were being intentionally goofy in the beginning, but we did have input.
Dancing, chocolate, monster match. I love this segment.
In addition to the pitch segment, we also will be sharing a little bit of a different take on Rob showing us how the mechanics of the sliding door actually work, which actually led to the title of our documentary, Behind the Sliding Door, because Rob was behind the sliding door.
Yes, that is where the sliding door title came from, and also the coin phrase, the wall people, came from me. Nobody else. That's right, Christopher R. Mim. It came from me. 3 years before your movie.
And then finally, Liz, I'll be like, fine. Just basically argue with me until I finally give in, okay? Like you normally would. And then at that point...
I'm gonna provoke that bullshit.
We're all stopping.
The doorman.
Let's see if I have this down. You're in the way, man.
Okay, let's see.
see if he passes the test.
You can get a shot of that.
It's pretty heavy.
Okay, this is the bottom, right?
That's the bottom. That's open. So like I said, the easiest way to do it, especially the bottom, is to get your shot. Get good shot. It's usually easier to go straight across.
Straight across.
So the bottom, honestly, is just...
Now is really where the fake documentary footage stops. At this point, we really tried to get behind the scenes of the making of the movie. As you will notice from the clips, and even in the documentary, I tried to stay in character as much as I could through the shoot, so please excuse the chauvinistic behavior. That is not me, that is just me trying to stay in the character of Dr. Banks. As you know, he is a pig.
Sure, Bob. We all know the truth.
And then you smile, and then you guys walk up the front, and you sit back down, and you pick up your sandwich, and then...
Look, I need that Oreo.
Bob says his last line.
Damn.
He's working it already.
Oh, my last line? Should have waited till dinner anyway. We asked for lunch.
No one asked you, Tony.
Yep, of course, Tony. You think it's hilarious.
So you take a victory seat.
Yep. That's basically what
whatever.
Happens.
So are we placing? Places.
Mr. Dragon, McKeon is...
Have a couple bites.
Oh my god, can I? Yes!
You, don't touch yours.
Tempting, isn't it?
Alright, so one thing I want to do
is really
do it this way.
Alright.
Yeah. To make sure that you're not totally
one white bread reminds me of being a kid.
Okay.
just two is fine.
Oh, non-essential.
When I was a kid, I hated wheat.
You're not non-essential, you're script boy.
If you're,
script boy!
Working it.
Pan it around.
Give new meaning to the word twofer.
Yeah.
Easy, tiger, easy.
Yes.
Yes.
Nice.
And.
Dos.
Action.
Well, hello there. You must be new.
Sorry, not interested.
Oh, honey, didn't you get enough sleep last night?
Very funny. Last night. Ugh. It was rough, and you know it.
Mm. Sorry, can we go again? I'm sorry.
God, yes.
Sorry.
What happened? I'm leaning where I am.
It was me going.
Oh, sound like you're.
Not yet.
I'm gonna do one more from this more close angle, cause so I can get your hand gestures and all that good stuff. So that being said, we need to get rid of the Tower of Half-Eaten Cookies here. Yummy. Look at this stack.
You can make mud later.
That's one hell of a hand right there.
Mm-hmm.
Good job. I've had that hand before. Creature of the man.
Ooh, it's all shiny. Need to lose some lights. There's one of these.
This one here?
Yeah. So there should be an off switch.
This one? Or just the whole thing?
No. Too dark. One more that's reflecting really bad. Let's see. It's that one right there. There's a switch on. Michael was -9.
Yeah.
This kid wasn't even born for another 20 plus years.
I was born in 71.
What year were you born in?
59. None of you is making what a year friend were you born here. In? 62.
Oh, okay, so at least he's the oldest
one. Hey, I'm in the ballpark. 1 year out.
A decade in a year.
But I'm in the ballpark. I'm in the crowd.
You're in the peanut gallery, mister.
Finally, to wrap things up, we do have some outtakes from the Attack of the Moon Zombies premiere segment. Can you believe that it has almost been 10 years since the premiere of Attack of the Moon Zombies? That is one reason why we wanted to release this now, to celebrate the up-and-coming anniversary of that movie.
The main challenge with this event was the noise. As you can see from the outside footage, we had to deal with passing vehicles, including a bus. It's cool visually, but we had a lot of limitations.
We also had some unplanned distractions, as you can see.
Hey, Bob, how about Mrs. Banks winning the car?
Oh, yeah. Also, I wanted to let you know that I included a piece of footage from the premiere that has Dr. Cryptosis giving away his new car to somebody. I ended up excluding this footage because I said a joke during the premiere that really nobody understood, and you can see by the reaction during the premiere that nobody understood what I was saying. And what I said when we gave the new car away to this beautiful woman is that this was Dr. Banks' wife, and nobody got it and nobody laughed. Well, the fact is, who you see in this segment is really my wife, and that is why I said that. And no one really got it. So I know my wife probably appreciated that I cut her out of the original footage, but you know, it's been almost 10 years and I figured, hey, I wanted to share this with all of you, so you'll also be able to see this little piece about me giving the new car to my wife.
It also has been almost 10 years since the premiere. I think Mrs. Banks would be okay with it now, right?
I hope. Also, this will be the last grouping of footage that we will be sharing with you from our outtakes and bloopers. I hope you really enjoyed them.
Please remember to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, He's in the Cooler, if you like this video. Also, please like this video if you really, really like it. Because we like you, and we might make more if you like us a lot.
Who knows? We might come up with some new stuff to talk about other than Attack of the Moon Zombies.
Yeah, like the giant spider!
No, Rob, we have beat that horse to death.
Okay. Bye, everybody. See you later. Bye.
Bye.
Well, Bob, we're at the premiere. Isn't this awesome?
Yes.
Attack of the Moon Zombies.
Right there.
Right there. This is going to be awesome. The movie is it's exciting. And wait, one second. I got a question, man. What's up with this movie? You look a lot different than what the fans have seen in your other films. What's going on behind the scenes?
Well,
I would say
it's Sid Corby. She's like a method actress, so she doesn't like my character, Dr. Banks, too much, so I had to change how I look.
Are you telling me you're afraid?
Yes, I am afraid for my life. She's like out there, so.
Could she be behind you right now?
I hope not.
Well, fans, well, anyway. you'll have to stay tuned, but I'll try to protect Bob, but you know, Sid Corby.
Yeah, we'll see.
We'll see what happens here.
All right, well.
But enjoy the ride. This is going to be a great experience.
Yeah.
And
we'll
and,
start you out here with an interview with Mitch Gonzalez, and we'll be right back. Okay. A lot of noise out here, so
yeah,
we'll see all the wind. Hey, I have one question, and I think the viewers have the same question.
actress, so she really gets into the role, and I'm a little afraid of her. Are you telling me you're afraid of Sid? Not me. I mean, it's been a great experience. You're going to enjoy this night. Just have a great time. And
we're going to start out right now with an interview with Mitch Gonzalez.
All right. Sounds good.
Now, you know what? You both come here on your own. I know that. You heard about the big drawing, right, for the car giveaway? Yes, yes. Yes, indeed. Now, there's... Oh, wait. I think I see the lucky recipient for this. This lady right here.
Here, you won the car.
She won the car. She lived down here. Don't drive it too much, okay? I don't know how long it'll last. Anyway, this
is merchandise, and we have cake. And we will bring out our friendly neighborhood Moon Zombie. And if you all want to line up and get pictures with it. That's
Bob.
Fine.
Cast.
And
cast.
Bob.
Cast out front.
Draw one more number.
Yes.
The new car.
The new car.
Oh, the new car.
Oh. Now all these other people see the
kids. You have four numbers in that basket?
There's two more.
978-132.
Oh, for the new car?
For the new car. See how much there is away. No one wants your new car.
Go out another number, then. You must be here to win.
978-123.
Jump up.
That's what you got.
Jump up.
Go ahead, jump up. So what's the new car?
Here you are. It's brand spanking new.
New car. I think that was Mrs. Banks. All right. Do we have another new car, or is that it?
No, that's it. Oprah, what do you got?
Mark was staring at me.
Well, Bob, this has been a great experience. I've loved it.